إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ربي وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. All praise due to Allah, we praise Him, we seek His help, we seek His forgiveness, and we seek refuge from Allah from the evils of ourselves and from the evils which result from our deeds. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided, no one can ever misguide. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguided, no one can ever guide. And I've been witness, there is no God worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one without any alternative. And I've been witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the last messenger of Allah. وَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أجارني الله وإياكم وجميع المسلمين والمسلمات من النار. Indeed, the most truthful book of speech is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst source is the new innovation in religion. And every new innovation in religion is misguidance, and every misguidance lead automatically to hellfire. May Allah save us all. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there is no book which readers, researchers, scholars have studied better than the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Qur'an. It is our guidance in this life. It is the book which involves everything benefiting us in this life. We, every one of us, have to follow it and to adapt to it, and to study it and to live with the Qur'an, which is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to follow this Qur'an, which is the word of Him. And He says in the Qur'an, وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. This is a book we have revealed, blessed. Follow it, and it is guard against evil, that mercy might be showing to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, is commanding us to follow this Qur'an. And unfortunately, we follow other books and we forget about the Qur'an. It is the best book which was revealed through the best angle, to the best land, in the best cave, during the best night, in the best month, with the beautiful language and best language to the greatest Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us an example how strong is this Qur'an and how powerful is the words of the Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Qur'an, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَىٰ جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِّنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَضْرِبُهَا لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Had we sat down this Qur'an in a mountain, You will certainly have seen it falling down, splitting asunder because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we send for those an example to man that they may reflect. My dear brothers and sisters, how strong are we ourselves comparing to the mountain? How big are we comparing to the mountain? How heights are we comparing to the mountain? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given us this example. And He said, if this Qur'an was revealed to a mountain, you will see the mountain splitting out and feeling down because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What about ourselves? Did we realize this one time? Did we study the Qur'an and we live with the Qur'an? Did we schedule a time for ourselves to recite the Qur'an and to study it? Did we put a reminder to remind ourselves every day to study the Qur'an and to review it? It is very important, my brothers and sisters, to be among the people of the Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And we revealed of the Qur'an that which is a healing and mercy to whom? To the believers, to us. May Allah make us among the believers. So for those who are complaining from sickness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to us this Qur'an and it can be as a occurrence according to Allah's words. Unfortunately, people when they get sick, they keep asking, who is the professional best doctors we can visit? Where is the best hospital we can go? And they can travel from one country to another country, but they forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already revealed to them the Qur'an, which can be a healing and mercy to them. And in terms of rewards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is cautioning us that we have to adapt to this Qur'an, which is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for those who are being blind in this life, they will be raised a blind in the day of judgment according to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran. He says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. Whomever turns away from my reminder, he shall be a strange life, and we will raise him in the day of resurrection blind. And unfortunately, as usual, human beings always arguing, and he will start to argue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he will say, قَالَ رَبِّي لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا. He shall say, Oh my Lord, why hast thou raised me a blind, and I was seeing indeed. He was among the people who sees in this life, but thereafter he was blind because he was blind in this life, not looking into the Quran, studying the Quran, reciting the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to this person and he said, قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. May Allah save us. He will say, even though our communication came to you, but you neglected them, even thus shall you be forsaking this day? Meaning, shall you be neglected this day because you neglected our communication during the life? And today we are neglecting you. Don't forget about the communication between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can directly communicate and speak with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nowadays, if you want to have a meeting or to communicate or to speak with a high authorities or high persons levels, you need a days or weeks to have this meeting or to speak with him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the King, above everything, you can directly and speak with him. The scholar says, if the persons want to speak directly with Allah, he can recite the book of Allah, which is the Qur'an. And if he wants to be in a communication between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he can perform the prayers. So communications and speaking to Allah directly can be done through prayers and reciting the Qur'an. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanding us to recite the Qur'an as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to read the Qur'an, and he told him, read. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه اقرأوا الزهروين البقرة وآل عمران فإنهما يأتيان يوم القيامة كأنهما غمامتان أو غيايتان أو كأنهما فرقان من طير صواف تحاجان عن أصحابهما اقرأوا سورة البقرة فإن أخذها بركة وتركها حسرة ولا تستطيع لها البطلة أي السحرة. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving us a beautiful advice which we can live in our life and we can be saved from the evils and from the eye evils of humans. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, recite the Quran, for in the day of resurrection it will come as an intercessor for those who recite the two bright ones, Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Al-Imran, which is the second and third Surah of Al-Quran. For in the day of resurrection, they will come as a two clouds in our two shades, bleeding for those who recite them. And nowadays, when they are alive, when they die, the deal is finished. Recite Surah Al-Baqarah. For those who recite them, they will be blessed. And if you forget about it, you will cause of grave, and the magicians cannot confer it. So those who are complaining from the magicians, who are complaining from the evil's eye, who are complaining from sicknesses, read the Quran, my brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send it to us to recite it, to review it, to study it, to memorize it, and to live with it. But unfortunately nowadays, you can see the person influenced by the new technology and smart technology. You can see the person is spending hours and hours reading the messages through his phone and reading the emails in his computer, whatever technology is. I'm not against the technology. But it is very important that you keep time for yourself to recite the Quran. We have 24 hours a day. You only need to spend half hour a day to recite one juz a day. Did you remind yourself and you put the reminder in your phone to remind yourself to recite a half hour a day, which can be one juz? My dear brothers and sisters, it is very important to be and your family, your children's, and whomever you can help among the people of Quran. May Allah make us among the people of Quran. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ربي وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My dear brothers and sisters, it is very important and critical while we are still alive to be among the people of Qur'an, to study and review the Qur'an and to live with the Qur'an. I remember one of the scholars who fully memorized the Qur'an, and he is explaining about himself. He said, one day I was preparing myself and gathering my books, going to study an English class. And I walked in the front of my dad, and my dad saw me preparing myself and carrying the books, and he called me. He asked me, "Where are you going?" I told him, "I'm going to study an English class. I want to strengthen myself in English." And he did not tell him not to study. My dear brothers and sisters, you gain knowledge as much as you can. We are not against knowledge. It is very important for you to live. But the knowledge of Quran is totally different. Then he told his son, "Do you see all the businesses that we have?" He said, "Yes." He said, "I don't speak English. And the English will not make you success in this life." And he told him and advised him, "If you want to be among the successful people in this life and thereafter, this is the book which you have to adopt, which is the Quran. And this is according to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah says, 'Man kana yuridu harutha al-akhirati nazid lahu fi harutih. وَمَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ حَرْثَ الدُّنْيَا نُؤْتِهِ مِنْهَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ نَصِيبٍ." Whomever desire the gain of hereafter, we will give him more of that gain. And whomever desire the gain of this world, we will give him of it. And in the hereafter, he has no portion. Don't you want to be among the people who have the desire and the gain here and thereafter, who have the successful here and thereafter, who have the profession here and thereafter, who have the happiness here and thereafter? Are you only seeking for the desire and gain of this life? It is your decision. Allah is clarified that whomever want to be among the successful people, we have revealed to you the Quran to live with it. One letter equal to one reward, according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, "Man qara'a harfan min kitabillah falahu bihi hasanah. والحسنة بعشر أمثالها لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Whomever recite a letter from the Quran, which is the book of Allah, he will be credited with good deed. And a good deed gets a tenfold reward." I do not say that alif, lam, mim, one letter. But alif is one letter. And lam is one letter. And mim is one letter. So you get three good deeds. And it goes to 30 good deeds and rewards. Have you ever thought about it? If you have recited the whole Quran, how much reward you will get? Approximately, the scholar says there are about 3,236,710 letters in the Quran. You are talking about millions of rewards. So if you give yourself half hour a day
to recite one juz. So 3 million divided by what? By 30, it's almost 100,000 rewards of good deeds that you can get in reciting one juz a day and giving half hour of your day to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, I only want you to benefit from this lecture with these 2 points and to keep it always in your mind and in the front of you wherever you go, and your family, your kids, whomever is relative to you. First of all, schedule yourself a time to recite the Quran before the time comes. Second, teach your family, your kids, gather them. Teach them the Quran the way it was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And if you are among the people who cannot recite the Quran in the way it was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, register yourself in any Quran center now in Qatar here. Alhamdulillah, we have too many Quran centers. Register yourself, your families, your kids, and study the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you want to be success, and to keep remind yourself and your family that the Quran is the only successful book that you can adapt to it. Other books is knowledgeable for this life, and the Quran is the successful for this life and hereafter. May Allah make us among the people of Quran.